voters of 15 constituencies in Karnataka have decided who their MLA will be. The rest of the world, including these MLAs, will only know this when the results come out on Monday. The BJP stands to lose Karnataka, the only southern state under their rule, if they don't win 7 out of these 15 seats. The exit polls give BJP 10 to 12 seats, which is a matter of joy for the party. However, the exit polls don't have a great record in the recent past. So here are some of the post-poll scenarios in Karnataka that we might see in the coming days. If the exit poll predictions come true and the BJP wins 7 seats in Karnataka, it'll be a relief for the Saffron party as they would retain power. But this won't be the end of their problems. In the run-up to the election, senior BJP leaders had claimed the party would win 15 out of 15 seats in Karnataka. But in reality, they will be happy with winning 10 seats. Surprised? Well, it has to do with the portfolio allocations. All disqualified MLAs were promised a cabinet berth by the BJP when they approached with a plan of changing camps. Now, there are only 34 cabinet berths available in Karnataka. And according to an internal study of the BJP, there are 56 leaders in the party who have won more than 3 elections or work hard enough to deserve a shot at being a minister. If more than 10 disqualified MLAs get elected, some BJP loyalists might lose out on a chance to become a minister. Already there are some who are disgruntled by the fact that they are not ministers, and this problem could increase in the future. Winning 10 seats would put the BJP in a comfortable position with 116 seats in the assembly. In such a scenario, the BJP would prefer the flexibility of having free cabinet posts for the loyalists to keep disgruntlement at bay. But what if the exit poll predictions are wrong and the BJP doesn't get enough seats to retain power? Then there are 3 possibilities. First, if they are short by just 1 seat, there are possibilities of them approaching an independent to fill this gap. According to exit polls, an independent candidate, Sharad Bachegowda, has a good chance of winning from the Hoskote constituency. Even though he was expelled from the BJP for contesting as an independent, acting against the wishes of the party, it is possible that they'll bury the hatchet and approach him because the difference is of just 1 seat. The second option for the BJP is to approach the JDS, who have already shown interest in joining hands. But this depends on how many seats will the JDS win. The exit polls in JDS's case differ from 0 to 2. Now, the third option is for the Congress and the JDS to join hands once again. In the days leading to the election, senior Congress leader Mallikarjun Kharge had said that the Congress is open to another alliance with the JDS if required. But this depends on how many seats they win. Currently, the JDS and the Congress together have 101 seats in the Karnataka Assembly. But to reach the magic number of 112, they will have to win at least 11 seats in this bipoll. For now, we will have to wait for Monday's results. And if things don't go in the BJP's favor, the state will have to endure another round of political uncertainty.